There we are live. Hi. Oh, thank you, Susan. Thank you, thank you. I just have to find this one on my channel so I can see the chat better. So I don't have to. No, that didn't want to come up there. Let me see. I did not. How come I can't see that now? Let's try again. And I got some notifications. There. No, I think I found it. Oh, and I have to cut that sound. Oh. There. Hi, Martina. And hi, Susan. There, and now I can see the chat a little bit better. So that makes it all easier. I'm fine, thank you, Susan. How are you? I'm actually very fine. It's Tuesday. And I got some time to come here and sit down with you, and if you hear animals running around, it's my two dogs that are having fun. So, I thought that we are always going to keep working on our Handsome Hunk. This image is from the book Handsome Hunks by Nathaniel Wake. I will put some links in the chat for you. You can see a full flip-through of this book at Nathaniel's channel. There is that flip-through of the book. Melody, good morning! Hi, sweetheart! Good to see you. So this is, and you can get this book from Amazon. So I will pop you a link for that, for those that wants. And this there is the Amazon link. And then we have his webpage, nathanielwake.com. Let's see if I can get that there. There are the links. So you all have that if you want to see, and my dogs are coming again in full speed. So today I want to work on the guitar and the belt, and let's see if we can get something more. I think that the guitar and belt will actually take some time. So. So let's just see. I want this guitar to be red. So, and to save ourselves some time, I want to just make a red base layer where I want that. This is just a regular pro marker. Which is poppy red. So, nothing fancy. So I will just pop the base down first, and then we can zoom in and show the, or zoom in better when we are doing some more detail work. And I think I actually have to go around all of that. And I want some of this to be white as well, but some of this got to be red. I think that we will do like that. And maybe a little bit in like there. So how are you all in on this Tuesday? I was about to say morning, but it isn't morning for Everybody body this morning just for some. For me, it's actually noon now. And so far, I've not been doing anything much really. I've just been. I've got the youngest one up, ready for school. I had a shower, something to eat. I've not really been doing much. Oh, this puppy red looks like it's going to dry up on me. But I have a spare. So for those of you who follow along, just take any marker. Oh my god. See where I have my spell on. Let's hope that this is better. Oh, that was much better. Yeah, that makes it so much easier to work with. And I will put that away, so I don't put that back in my box. Oh, somebody is coming home. Guess that is my hubby. He's been oh, fishing. What is this? And this might not look as very much yet, but we will make it work. Yeah. Okay, right down there. Kjartan, I
live. Oh, sorry.
Sorry. Oh, I've got mail. Look what I've got the world of an anime special from Coloring Heaven. I didn't think that I was going to get any more of these ones. Okay. No, I have to check that out because I had cancelled my subs. Garrison. Hi, Silla. And Charlotte, good morning. So, where to put this? Which part to have red on, which part of I actually do think that I want to match this part. Put red on here. Still can see that, and I will zoom in when we get a little bit, or we get to the pencil work. Now, this I'm only doing to save time. So if you want to color this all with just pencil, then be my guest. I think that I actually have to put some red in here. I don't have to, but I think that I want to. I'm decorating this guitar. Like that, maybe. And this part can be white and gray or steel. How I am. Charlotte, I'm good. I'm very good. It's been a great day so far. I haven't done anything really. Katrine, good morning. It's And so we need a darker red and some other. So my darkest red now is the Tuscan red. That's the 937 and I'll call her, of course. Both of these are that. And the second one is crimson red, 924. Then we actually can zoom in a little bit. I can pull my hunk a little bit down so we can color the top. Okay, go ahead, Katrine. That is quite okay, like that. Hopefully it will stay okay and not get burned. Baller. And it looks like it got a bit darker here. Yes, I'm going back to the hunky Jesus. I was told that some are actually called coloring along with me and wanted me to show it all on camera, and of course I said yes. So then we kind of have to do it, so I will do this live event today and do the rest on a recording, I think, because I don't think that we'll make it today. I'm just putting this Tuscan red down where I want some shades, so that is around this white border thing and around the edge of the guitar head. Today I'm coloring with Prisma color. This red here is just a base with a Peru marker, alcohol based marker, which is puppy red. And it looks like my light disappeared outside because it suddenly got way darker in here. Right. So I will then take this crimson red. Actually, it got too dark. I will try to turn on the light so I actually get to see it. It looks good on my camera, but for me. Oh, that turned yellow. Well, hopefully it will. Okay. I need to have my hand. Close by. So, I'm smoothing out those edges with that crimson, and I'm going back with my Tuscan red back and forth. Until I have it as I would like it to be. Hopefully it will look better when we got the silver going and the white on there as well. So we will move further down on the guitar. I am Catherine. Thank you. That's so. I don't know the English word, but it makes me very, very humble. And I'm your favorite part on Tuesdays. That's awesome. Again, going in with this Tuscan red it. Maybe I've zoomed in a little bit too much. At least you get to see on the outer edges. Putting back in those lines that were here. Shadow up here. There, changing again to the crimson red and just putting some of that in from the edge, from the darkest or from the Tuscan red. Leaving the marker base as a highlight. Hi, Morticia. If I didn't say hi. Melody, this is on manga paper, so I took it out and put it on manga paper. Just because I have some so much of it, and I don't really like it that much. Or I like it for markers, just not for pencils. So I don't have the physical copy. Belinda, hi, welcome. Oh my God, I'm so zoomed in. Maybe I actually should zoom out a little bit so you can see a little bit more, because this was just crazy like that, maybe. So you. I don't know if you have seen. This is my hunky Jesus guitarist. So we are working on his guitar today. So I'm just getting those lines back in and adding this Tuscan red into the darkest areas. Just like I did on the other side and on that head. I think it's called a guitar head. Hopefully it is. There. Going in with this crimson red. No, I could actually have chosen an even darker red for this middle color, but the Tuscan red again around that plate and around all the edges. I'm getting a nice darker line there. Hi, Starbox. Hi and welcome. Elizabeth, good morning. Awesome to see so many being up this early. Or I guess it's early more or less only for the Americans. Rest of the world have been up for some hours. At least I know Melody and Belinda have been up. Time. A bit there. Good morning, Catherine. It's 6:19 there. Yeah, that's early. Hi, Sammy. Good morning. Or actually, good noon. Afternoon. Just actually, it should be quite darker in there because it goes. I'm gonna use that task in order to darken that up a little bit more. And now my little pup wants to get up on his on this shelf that I'm having next to my working area, so I'll just have to lift her up. It's not easy getting that down both up there at the same time. So then we can keep working on. So I think that we need that part to be a bit darker as well. A little bit of that Tuscan red on here, giving the guitar some shape. Hopefully you can see there. My snoring puppies, where she loves to be, right next to me. This plate a little bit. So is any one of you doing something to the day? Maybe you are waiting for some exciting books. If you are, let me know because I'm all always on the lookout for some new books. So please tell me if you are inventing something. Oh, you're at the new hospital. One more day. Well, yeah, then you need your charger. And it's that with the bad Wi-Fi. Or not bad, but limited. That's quite weird that the hospital actually has that. Yeah, well, can't your assistant get up some pencils and a book as well then? Bedding you so you actually have them, so maybe you, if you can't color that much, at least you can sit and hold them and pay attend at your coloring. Or just be looking at those nice colors. A little bit more of those shadow areas there, I think. Just take the crimson. And going around there, just soften that up, but not going over it all because I want to keep some highlights. And I got this notification, so I got to be so I'm able to stop them while I'm live. And Debs, hi! Welcome! Good to see you. I think I might have to soften this out a little bit. Because that line got a little bit too hard. I don't really like that. So I just soften it out. Have you girls checked out this book yet? You really should. Oh, and Charlotte, I have painted out that spiker. I wanted to show you that. I'll show you him. If I know where I put it now. Let me see. That more tone found. Here, Charlotte, look at this. This is, I have to zoom out. I'll show him. There is the biker guy. Biker dude. So I'm going to do him. And this is our hunter. Ah, yes. Look at this guy. This is one handsome hunk. But you can watch the full Pelipsen by that link that I posted, and I will post it again in the end of this. Well, Elizabeth, about if you don't like skin, then this might not be your kind of book. But of course, you can give them a shirt. Just mark off lines. Hi, Terry. Well, you can get this book I have posted links to when I started it, and I will be posting links again closer to the end. So. Now I'm having a cold gray marker out. Just want to mark out where the buttons and stuff are. I think those are buttons as well. Isn't those? And I need to mark off what I want to be white and what I want to be, or what I want chrome color. At least I want that one to be chrome color. I don't know about this long neck, what color? What that? Lilac maybe? Or chrome color that as well, so it actually matches up. I think I want that. Then I can I think all girls who, or not only girls, but everybody who like a real good hunk needs this book in their lives. So you can actually can see and look at all of these hunks. They are amazing. Nathaniel makes these awesome images. That and oh God, this is hard. I want that to be chrome and maybe this to be oops, there I'm pulling some of that pencils with me. Okay. From there. And what about here? Yeah, let's take this one there. Yeah, let's just see. Thank you, Charlotte. And Belinda will be giving away one of these books next month. So you should pop over if you don't follow Belinda, then where in the world have you been? And you should jump over because she do amazing tutorials. And she has live shows and color alongs. And she is just amazing. You can learn so much from her. So we need some cool grays out since this is a dead thing. We don't want the warm. This, but we want those cold ones. So I've just pulled out cool gray 90%, 1067. Cool gray, what is this, that? 30%, I think, 1066 one, and cool gray 20. 1060. So let's see if this. Good morning, Kate. Thank you. You will have four of his books in the December. That's awesome. Oh my God. Well, I will be joining in then. Just take this darkest one then. And going over to the medium. And then last to the lightest color like that. And that part which is white, I want to keep white, but you didn't see that. The darkest one, maybe I actually need one more to be. Maybe I need the 50%. will be too. Actually, making that straight line. Hopefully, we are able to do that like that. Those won't be showing later. Yes, Catherine, you should check him out. He is amazing. And Linda colored Ferran one of his Dragon books last week. Yeah, or maybe it was a weekend. My days are kind of just floating together. But she colored that and did an amazing job. So that video should be up. So you can check out. And she also did a little of that book. But I guess that he has a flip through of all of his books on his YouTube channel. I can post that link again to flip through of this book, and there you will find his channel, and you can look around, check out all of his books. He has quite a few out now. I know, Catherine, that was a gorgeous book. So amazing. That maybe. It has to come further down. Something like that, maybe. I've pulled out my 70% as well. I will go step on the other side just to mark off those edges a little bit. Oh god. This would be easier with a marker. You are Catherine, awesome. Well, the dragons are cool all year round. That line around that. Maybe they will arc those in the section out a little bit with this 70% as well. That. That. We don't have to make it precisely. So this is the 30%. Actually, that should actually be that, but why don't I have this 50%? Where have I done that? There, this is the 50. So, working. So we have 70% cool grey on the outer edges, and we have the That was the 50. Looking a little bit up there. Like that. Oh my god, those pencils. Yeah, 30. Going down. His finger. That, and we need a little bit more shadow down there. One with 30%. Oh, I do actually need that 50 back, because we need a little bit more shadow under that plate there. That. I'm going in with the 20%. Just lightly blending. And it's not, oh, we need some darker areas or some sort of under these fingers here. So I'm just putting those in right now. There. Then back with the 20, blending it all in. A little bit as well. There. That. Okay, Elinda, I hope that you have a nice nap. You are a Bengal. Yeah. I'm so happy to see so many having cats here. Well, Bengals are awesome. I do love mine. But of course, if you haven't had a cat that is bossy and demanding, you should not start out with a Bengal. It can be quite a lot to handle if you don't know what you actually are getting, because Bengals are not just like any other house cat. But as long as you know what you are getting and getting yourself out with, then you should do fine. But they are something. They are loud, they are chatty, they are demanding. They don't only think that they are the boss of the world, but they know that they are. But they are also extremely loyal, to the point that you will never have to walk alone again, ever. Which can be quite cute in the beginning, but after some years. Yeah, they should actually tell you. Yeah, they should come with a warning sign. Actually, because they are really not like other cats. People who think that a cat is a cat have never met a Bengal. They They are not just a cat. And what I'm doing here, I'm just starting out with the darkest gray and working my way down into this pattern here. I will do that. I will zoom in a little bit. Oops. Yeah, okay. A little bit did not work, so we zoomed in a whole lot. I will try to zoom out a little bit then, because we can't be this close. Come on. Come on. Why can't I? Oh, maybe. Yeah. That's better. Like that. Yeah. Catherine, my son said something the other day, and that is just so true, because how do you know that the world isn't flat? Because if it had been, a Bengal would have pushed something over the edge. You saw his nipple, yeah. Of course he got to have a nipple. He's a rock star. And when he told me that, I was like, yeah, that is so taru. My male, he is the smartest one. He is really something else. He can open the kitchen counter. He and when his dry food bowl is starting, or when it doesn't have a top on it, when it's kind of flat, then he is freaking out and thinking that he's going to die or starvation, and he starts pushing it around, wanting me to peel it up. And if I ignore him, he flips it, so all his food actually falls out. Then he's sitting in the middle of his food and yelling at me. And of course, then he actually is right. He doesn't have any food left because in his bowl, because he emptied it. So. So he is very smart like that. And hi, Nick and Tina. And welcome. He always pushes things over the edge and giving it for the dogs to lay with. Like that, maybe. Hopefully you still can see it. I think Well, thank you, Bella. And by the way, I know you, or I love your name. And Bella actually means beautiful on Italian. So you have a gorgeous name. My one female Bengal is called Arabella, but we only call her Bella. Or not only, but mostly we call her Bella. So I'm starting with the darkest of my cool grays and working my way to the lighter parts again. Like that. Should have. And I'm not gonna really put stuff on tables, but yeah, some play with myself after that. No, that's. They just like to push it over and see what have happened and listen to the sound. Oh, one of Pickles is called Bella too. You didn't know that, Bella. Well, now you do. So yes, Bella is the Italian word for beautiful in the Lady and the Tramp movie. They are singing about the Bella Notta, and that means beautiful night. I don't know if they sing on English in the American version, and if they have changed the lyrics, or if they actually sing about Bella Notta there as well. But they should. I'm just going around here putting this embellishment. I think that's the English word for it. And now both of my dogs are sleeping, so you might be able to hear both big snoring and little snoring. I'm just having some fun here, putting this cool gaze down here and there. Hi, Louise, and welcome. Good morning, or good day, or good evening, depending on where in the world you are. Like that. I think that we are. Oh, we need to do something with that plate. Not quite keep doing it. This one, this is the 70%. battery. No, that's the 50. There's 30. Working my way in. Blending tools in there. Because I do think that this middle part should be better. That should be a bit darker. So just so you, so it makes a difference and doesn't look so flat. Maybe like that. You're from UK, so it's morning. Well, isn't it noon? I thought that you had noon in UK now. So we have to do something with this white parts as well, so we don't leave them. Okay, Catherine, take care and have a nice day. And if we are on, you are welcome back. Or you are welcome back anyways. I do believe that we should use some cream or some. This is a nice color. What's that? That's eggshell. For this. When I grew white, I often use yellow, actually. I don't color white, I color light yellow or light blue or something like that. Not cream. But I don't. Okay, so I have eggshell out and I have cream, and maybe I should use some beige or something like that. Just to make it a little bit darker. Oh, we have this nice grayish color here. What's this? This is putty beige. That sounds like a good color. Oops. So I have taken out eggshell, cream, and putty beige. Just to bring a little bit more life into this white area, because I do want it white, but I don't want it in your face white. And I'm picking up some dust. So this is the cream. I'm just putting that on there and there. I think that is actually a finger. We have, or I have gotten to color. He's picking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's a finger. We need to color in that. Again, putting down this my darkest color, and this is cream. In the or on the edges or the shadowed areas, and this we are smearing that red. That I don't really like that we are doing. Changing it to the eggshell. Oh, actually, this eggshell was quite darker than the cream color was. But that's okay. It still gives it some depth and interest when the color has a bad variation in it. Ooh, Kate, but if it doesn't work, so what? You're having fun, aren't you? And I don't think that you are making a mess. I'm with Pickle. You are way too hard on yourself. Usually you're doing just fine and you are making wonderful art. But you are way too hard on yourself. Oops. Yeah, okay, maybe down here as well. Like that, so it looks a little bit dirty. You probably have had that for a long time. And now I can blend all of that in with this white one. This is just a white Prisma color. Just smoothing it out. Like there. If you are making a mess, Kate, then so what? Like that. I actually like my guitar. There you go, Kate. Then you have reached your goal, haven't you? When you are relaxed with coffee, you got a candle burning and paint everywhere. Oops, I'll zoom out. By the way, I think that my light came back, so maybe I can turn this off so it doesn't look so yellow. Yeah, this works for me. Let me see how it looks on screen. Yeah, it's not that bad. So here is our guitar dude. This far. Oh, we have forgotten about that top. We need some yellow in that white as well. And then I will start with this eggshell, which I found out was actually the darkest one. And then cream color. Then a little bit of this. What was it? Putty beige. And then we need to get back in with the white. Blending that in. If you want this part to be whiter, you can go in with Posca or a gel pen and add white back in, and then you can soften it with pencil on top. We have some buttons over there, so we need a dark and bottom and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's got 6 buttons there. Like that. So I just started with the darkest cool gray, which was the 90, and then I have this 70% here, and I will blend those all of them out with the really light one. The 20% making round circles like that. Now some of this really lost the highlight, so I will take a Posca and go in with that. tänker, Charlotte. Tänker till Teddy. I really can't whistle. I never learned it. My hamster and kids and parents always tease me because I just can't whistle. I wish I could because it sounds awesome. So, he has a belt. We should find some brown color to this belt. So we have dark brown and we have burnt ochre. And then something yellowish. Or actually we have this eggshell out. I think that maybe we actually can use that. Let's see as we go. It's funny to whistle until your kids learn it. I don't know. Oops. Again, I really can't zoom just a little bit. There. That is on the wall, yeah. This is my dark brown. Again, putting this darkest color on the outer edges. The outline. That buckle, maybe we will keep that shiny as well. Maybe, no, that's not this buckle, that because this buckle should be around here. So that is just the end of the belt. We can't see his buckle. Well, then to the burnt ochre. See what happens if I put this eggshell in here, blending it with that. That wasn't bad. Okay, so again going in with the dark brown first. And this is how I usually work. Going from the dark, working my way into the light. So let's do the second round like there. This and then to the burnt ochre. And that out. And the lightest again. Oh, thank you, Mama Megs. Thank you. Well, who does not like a redecorated wall? So, oh, that finger, that poor pinky. I have to color it now, or else I might forget it. I'll just leave those there and find this. Okay. And for the skin, we use this Oh, they're not used to chocolate, I use. Oh, thank you, Charlotte. Is this dark? I don't go down there. Then I'm using peach and light peach. Then this light peach. So he actually got this pinky, so I don't forget that. I will list all these pencils and stuff when I have uploaded this. So then we should do speakers and background and wires. Is that what you call this stuff here? That's wires. I'll zoom you girls out so you can see the full picture. Like pulling him a little bit down like that. There is our rock god, not god, more Jesus, rocking Jesus. Or something. I think it looks awesome. But of course we should do those speakers. Put all these pencils down. I don't really know how you color speakers. I never colored one. But let's just jump into it. I guess most of them are black on the light gray circles and black in the middle. Or well, I can make them wooden. That would actually make it a little bit more colorful as well. Oh, thank you, Bella. Hi, Alicia. Oh, welcome. Good to see you. I don't know if I actually want that much more color because I want my hunk and guitar to be in the focus. So maybe I will just color these speakers grays, actually. I know, Pickle. He's looking good. I'm like, oh, did I make this? he looks good. So, speakers. I need some. A little bit sip of my coffee, and I need some cool grays. I have some touch markers is lying here next to me, so I can bring out some different cool Gaudi 05. That was really really light one. Look at that light color, cool gang. Gaudi 05, so it's a half. It's not even one. Cool gray is 3. And what more do we have here? Cool gray 2. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of cool grays actually. 3, 4, 5. Just pulling them all out maybe. All of this cool grays. 2, 7, 4. Oh my god, yeah. We have a lot of cool grays here. I actually have a black as well, but that I kind of never use that. Though I can use it on the inner parts. So. Hi, Suzanne. Welcome. Good to see you. Oh, Pickle, don't worry. By the way, my elephant man is in the shower now, so. My god, these markers really have a lot of cool grays. I haven't used this mucus that much yet. And I have mostly used the colored ones actually. So, what do we want? I do want that super light, cool gray. I think that looked good. And maybe we will use the cool gray 8 as our darkest. So then we have a super dark and super light, and something in between. One or two in between, I guess, as well. Like number 3 and 5, maybe. Yeah, I guess so. That should cover it. I just pulled out some alcohol markers, different cool grays, and that I will use as a base. Or let's see how far we are getting it, and if you, I need to put them in there. You can use all pencils as well, but as I oh live, I kind of don't have the time for doing all of this in just pencils. So this is my darkest cool gray. This is a cool gray number 8. That's what I want there, and I will also outline there and me and straight lines. That's just hopeless. I don't even think s that right. Oh. Forget it, I need a ruler. My God, I'm hopeless when it comes to straight lines and straight stuff. That's just not for me. But we have things who can help us on the way, actually. Where would I been without rulers and stuff? Not bad. Why do I think that I actually can make a steady line? I kind of never learn. Like there. Then we have a straight line up here, which obviously I can't make without a ruler. There. I will try to make that out the line as well. Yes. Okay, I'm not that hopeless when I have tools. Ta-da-da. How the touch compares to the Kalia art and the Ohuhu? I don't know actually, because I don't have any of the tones. I do have some cheaper versions of the Touch as well, called Touch 5 and Touch New. And there are really not that much of a difference. Biggest difference, of course, is that I can, like the Copics, I can fill these ones. I cannot fill my blue markers, but I can fill the chameleons and the touch markers. But for doing this, you doesn't need Copics. You can use any alcohol marker. So I'm just taking that off and then going in with the Cool Gray 5. Start for that shadow area and that one down here. Let's mark that out like that. Some of those marks here as well. Well, this one actually looked, well, was quite dark. Well, does that look darker than the first one? Well, it isn't. Okay, then we have the Cool Gray 3 and the lightest one. I will just start out with the lightest one, putting in just the base of that first there, so we have something down, so it will blend better when I work my way up here. I'm going in back in with the lightest one again, making them blend out to avoid those sharp edges. I'm focusing on keeping this marker line wet. Rubbing it until the line is soft. That is how I balance markers. Show you the advice that you got it. Lens nicely like that. I'm having a hand on top of this. I can't work like that. Good morning, Dorothy. Morticia is at the hospital, so she has some action going on around her. Now this actually was quite a light gray, maybe a little bit too light actually. I think I need that Cool Gray 1 or something. That. Yeah, there we have that. But it's nice to put it over for just wetting my area. Then I'm have this Cool Gray 3 again. Thank you. that up. And if this sound annoys you, then I'm terribly sorry. Oh, and I got a bit of that shadow there. There we are. Now that line around there should, that those circles, maybe they should be darker. Ooh, and of course we forgot this part down here. Okay, going back in with the color 3, which is my medium color. Then the cool gray 1. As long as your edge is wet, you can move it when you are using alcohol markers. Going in with the lightest of my cool grays as well. There. Oh, Dorothy, I'm good. I'm good. I hope that you'll have a wonderful day. I wonder what color we should have those circles. Or should we? If you want to, you can go in with pencils. Maybe we actually should have some cool grays out already, so we can have some fun with those. Maybe I should make those black actually. I don't know. This is the cool gray 90%. I'm just putting in some focus areas there. To be a little bit darker around the bottom here. I need, and the same back here, because the shades usually are quite dark. That blending that out a little bit. Working my way up. And there. Like that. It's 6 weeks until Christmas Eve. Awesome. I've not started to buy Christmas gifts right yet. Or I thought that I had, but I haven't, because we have some birthdays and stuff coming up, so. Those rings, I don't know, I will. This is the 70%. Just add that to the bottom. There. And then the 30%. Up there and there. And then the 20. Like that maybe. darken this bit up a little bit. Oh, it's on Facebook. Well, awesome. So there we have one speaker, more or less done, I think. I don't quite know yet what to add more, if we were going to add more. But how much time? We have been on 1.5 hours. So that was one speaker, and those wires, I will just take my darkest or the cool gray. So it was per 70. No, this is 90 actually. Percent. And this is the 70. So I'm just, so this is how I will color the wires as well. So the ones who follow along to see how I do it, and then you can choose how you want to do it. There. I am working my way from darkest to lighter areas from each side of this, because this it is round, so the outer edges will always seem darker just because of the shape, and the highlight will always go on the top. So that goes with wires or snakes and other stuff that are round. So this was the 30%. Then we have this 20 going up a little bit there. I can go back in with the 70%, because there was quite a big gap between the darkest and the second darkest. So to smoothen that out, I'm going in with the second darkest color, putting that next to the darkest line, like that. But then we have this 20%. Which is the lightest of the cool grays that we are working with. I'm blending everything just up like that. I'll brush a little bit wet. So I can use my white for blending in my highlight, so it doesn't look so hard white, like that. I can lift this up to you so you can see. So this is my wire, or cable, or whatever that's called. So, hi Kenneth. You did buy some Christmas presents, but Auntie is too soft and giving them. Yeah, I know. I do the same pickle. I'm buying Christmas gifts, and then I just can't wait to see the joy. So I'm giving them way too early, and then I have to buy more, but that's okay. So for background, I don't know, what kind of background do you girls and guys thinks that he needs to Balak. Or a really the dark one will make everything kind of pop. But I don't want to sit here and use a marker. And if I use the subcolors, that will go fast, but it won't make it really, really black. But I think that watercolor layers actually will make it look kind of good anyways. Let's put some stuff away here. And black and watercolors is actually a color that I hardly ever use. So, and I don't even know that I, yes, my Prima marketing set that I have here, that has black in it. I have put some extras. I bought three of these ones and I have just put an extra row in them because this one comes in 12, like the 6 up there and 6 down there, but you can actually get another line in and add three more there. So this tins actually holds a lot of off pants. So they are so worth it. But we need a brush. Let's take this one. This is my favorite. I think that we need to mix up some black. So I'm just adding a lot of water there. I'm not going to mix black on this one. So I'm just gonna use this Prima marketing black. I'm sure that will do good anyways. So but then I have to lift it so I can turn it and where do I want to start with this one? Maybe I'll just start up here. Needs to go down. It's so weird to give me a marker or a pen. I can't make a straight line. But if you hand me a brush, then I can. Or it's actually quite easier. That is just so weird. Because I should be able to do this with marker or pens as well. But no, not me. I wonder what my dogs have been eating because I can hear they actually fart. I don't smell it. Thank God, because a bulldog fart can actually kill you. But I can hear it and it's making me worried. It's a scary thing to hear your bulldog farting. Of God. And sorry for not talking, but I'm really bad at multitasking when it comes to watercoloring. And I'm missing all the chat as well. What, Kate? They are. I see that I'm going over some of Jesus' hair. But it will show the watercolors anyways, and if it doesn't, I'll just add them back in later on. Got to flip it a little bit. I don't know if I'm zoomed out completely. I think I am. So. No, but I need more paint. We need more paint. So I'm just picking up some water from my can over here and putting it in the little mixing area there. Then going back in with the brush in my paint. Up, putting the blending it in with the water like that. I don't know why that is going there, but it is. I should put on some music, but if I do, YouTube might ban me. Hamster has a TV on. Okay, so this is the most boring lives remember where the host don't even speak. But that's just how it got to be right now because I need to concentrate. Oh, it's Pico leaving us. Okay, goodbye, Pickle. Have a wonderful day. And I'll be seeing you around, I guess. And the light fast, yeah, Louise, those are awesome. I hope that you managed to get the full set. I almost have the full set now because I ordered some last night as well. It's because I have been getting some sun for them. Jack's not. And that's it's actually good where the back of the speaker, I think. So soon actually have the full set. So the next thing I'm going to work on getting is the venting refitent. There are only 24 colors and I have 6 by now. I want them all. I love the earthy tones like that. We have our Jesus, because I think that this back there is speakers as well, or maybe or at least it should be speakers. That, and I will put that to the side as well. Okay, Kate, have a wonderful day. And I'll talk to you sometime. Yeah, Louise, when I got my holder box, I got 30 new colors. So I was so happy. So this is as far as we have come with our guitarist. I think that he's actually coming out really nice. I just have to finish these speakers. But I will do them just the same as I did this one. Maybe use different shades of rays. But nothing too dark. Because I want him to stand out. So for those of you who are coloring along, now I have shown how I'm doing speakers, so you can do the same on the other ones. And I have showed the wire, which is there's coming one down here as well. So you should be able to just copy that and finish this picture. And I have bad like paint on my hands. But that's okay. Yeah, me too, Beth. It's awesome. I know it's dead early. So I can take this away. I'm putting him down. So this is our rocking Jesus, dude, so far. So this means that I will finish this picture off a camera, because I don't really have that much more to show you, and I will just repeat what I've already done. So I hope that you all have enjoyed this and find this inspired. Hiring. I will put on some links again to where you can get this book and stuff. So this is from the book Handsome Hunks by Nathaniel Wake. You can see the flip through of the full book here. It's 35 images, so it's quite a big book, and you can buy it from Amazon, and this is the link for that, for Amazon, and at nathanielwake.com. He also has a Facebook group, and I haven't opened that one, where he also gives away freebies. Nathaniel Wake is an awesome artist. And you should also jump over and check out Linda, that's facial girl, 1985. I can see if I can't find her as well here and post a link to her channel because she will be or she have colored the again a picture from Natant Panayev, and she will also be hosting some giveaways and some other fun stuff next month. And of course, I can't find her in my list right now because I have 200 that I've followed, so I kind of have to search for her. There. God, I can't even type anymore. Could not find her there either. Oh my God. There's so many faithful girls. I guess that she will be quite far down on my list because I have been following her like forever. Seriously, where in the world has she gone? Well, anyways, I will find it when I'm done here and I will link it. So, yes, Beth, if you could look as well, that would be awesome. Because I didn't find her right now. I know that she was in the chat, so I can go back up and look later on and link it. But thank you all for coming. And yes, the Fairies book is awesome, and I think I'm going to, and I need that as well. So, thank you all for coming. It has been so much fun. So, take care, everybody. Bye. There. There you see, Beth found it. Thank you so much. You are an angel. Okay, so take care. I will be back on Sunday for those of you who are able and awake then. And if not, I will be back on next Tuesday for on the same time as today. But that is next week, Sunday first. So take care, everybody. Thank you all for coming. And bye. Bye, Melody.